Up there, a snow biome. Oh, hi. Oh, 112. That's right, it's me, Scryptar. How you doing, folks? I'm doing great. We're back to another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. Hi. So, we're standing here on our trusty Stego Lady, currently trying to gather some resources for making more narcotics. Which is one of the tedious tasks you have to do just on a daily basis. It's one of the first things I like to do when I log in. There's a level for gathering, that's nice. So your weight is filling up quite nicely there. So we can't really carry too much. What are we looking? What do we need? What do we not need? We still have some regular berries, I'd like to call them, like all of these blue and yellow and whatever. The berries we really need are these three. You know, metal berries for taming, stims for making stimulants and all other kinds of stuff, and currently the most important one, narcotics, of course. So let's move all these seeds up here. I'd like to collect those so we don't have to go out and, you know, to the trouble of collecting them later on the spot when we actually need them. They don't really weigh anything, so why wouldn't you? Let's just move them up here. That should be pretty much all of them. Don't really need thatch. It's collecting thatch at a quite nice rate, so we can use this for thatch gathering and even to an extent for wood gathering. It's not the main purpose, though. So, let's move all the stuff that we want to keep up here. And get rid of the rest. You can just press O to chuck things out of your inventory. I actually take those right now because I already have some spoiled meat waiting in the mortar and pestle for us. And by getting rid of all of this, we have some more weight available to us. So, like I said, we are not going to really use up stamina too fast because we're staying close to home. Health, I'm not too overly worried about. It's a low-level dinosaur, and we have Rex standing by to assist us if anything shows up to cause us trouble. Melee damage helps in gathering rates. We do want that. I do want a little bit more movement speed. Was already at 194 when we got it, so those 5% won't really help much, but better than nothing. So the only drawback of doing this on a single player instead of multiplayer... Oh, thank you for the rain. Always forget about that. Is that... What am I saying? The only drawback is that whenever I switch off the game, the server won't do any work for me, right? So I put that meat in a box to spoil and I logged back in. I haven't done anything so far, so the timer for that spoilage is still where it was when I put it in there. Can you go out of my way? See, the area of effect is quite nice on this dinosaur. Try doing that by hand. And we're already overweight. So, where do we stop? There. Give me that. Oops. Well. Not to worry about all the stimmers. That's the last seeds we need. Yeah, that should be 10. That's all there is at the moment. And again, I chucked out some stimberries. Well, like I said, we don't really need them just now and we can get them fairly fast. So it's really, at the moment, I don't know why we're keeping them. I guess we just do. Because we can. To the trees. Move! Alright, same again. Need to get the weight up. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. That. And nothing of that. Just have to be careful when you press O. You see, this moves up and down, so you might actually hit the wrong berries when you press O. Hmm. Happens to the best. So, I'm going to continue doing so. Just gonna show you guys quickly what we're going to do with those berries. I mean, there's not much to it. I'm gonna go up here, as it lets us. And up here. And up there. And up here. down there. Parkour. And in here. Everything. Thank you. That looks better. So we still have pretty much enough Trank Arrows for everything we want to do today. Don't need more of that. We want to have narcotics standing by. I like to have a whole storage box full of narcotics. Like all 45 slots that we have there. Just in case. You never know what you need them for. I rearranged the pick and the hatchet here because this is the next spot I want to take care of. Number 6 in my list is always the spyglass. Spyglass enables you to, from afar, have a look at a dinosaur, see its level, and be able to determine if you want to tame it or not, or if it's any danger to you or not. For that, we need crystal, most of all. The rest of the ingredients we already have. Now, crystal is over there in the snow biome, so I'm going to get on our raptor, move over there, have a look if we can get to any of that crystal easily. The issue is, usually you need a metal pick for that. We could go up there. We have the metal pick unlocked. We could go and set up a smithy and a refining forge and everything we need to get into metal tools. Not just now. I want to have that over in our real starting base that we are going to start off as soon as we have aerial reconnaissance going. And for aerial reconnaissance, like we determined last time, we need 2 more levels to get the Pteranodon saddle. And Pteranodons are over there and all the way down there, as we have seen when we were taming this lady and that one. You are a lady, right? Yeah. Do we have any dudes? We're surrounded by females. Now, isn't that nice? Isn't that what you want? Be stranded on an island full of dinosaurs surrounded by females. Let's not talk about that. Good, so I'm gonna get on my raptor, get over there, and I meet you back once there's anything to see. Before we do that, I have one correction to make. When regarding the last episode, I said pretty much that there is nothing that could help you gather fiber fast. That's wrong. There is a metal sickle, which we can get fairly soon, which will do nothing but gather fiber from those bushes. It suggests that there's no other dinosaur where you could do it. Not just now. We could get one of the big apes, Gigantopithecus. As far as I remember, they only gather fiber when they're on wandering, not when you actually ride them. So, I was kind of right? Right? Kind of right? Here we are. This is the place we are going to set up shop. Over there, by that big lump of rock, we are going to have our base. This is a very flat sort of area, so we can put down a lot of foundations and don't have to worry about the terrain not letting us. And up there is going to be our starter home. So moving from there to there at a later stage will be fairly easy. Now what you can see here is that there's quite a few predators around. You see there's scorpions, saber-tooth. Up there, behind that rock where the snow starts, over my head, that's where the spawn point is for most of these predators. There's some raptors running around and whatnot. This little forest over there and this little forest over there is going to be our main wood and thatch supply. You can get enormous amounts of wood and thatch really, really quickly. Those tall rocks, that's our oil supply. Down there, you can see it glimmering there above my head. That's pearls. This area is full of pearls. Everything we need. There are some rocks here in the water, which will provide us with some metal. But the real metal is up there in the snow biome. So, we have everything here. There's bushes and everything. That is a really nice area to start off. It's just not the least dangerous area to be in. There's piranhas out here, there is sharks coming up to the shore and all of that. And there's some crystal. So, let's see if we can do this. We're currently freezing to death because we don't really have the protection we need to be here. Not just now. Well, we can move in and out quickly. Let's see if we get some. No, we don't. The chance of getting crystal with a stone head, with a stone pick, we're using the wrong tool, is fairly slim. So we might have to get on a number of these. We only need 2 crystal for the spyglass. So it's no really use postponing that until we get the metal tools. I want to try this at least. Well, there is a chance. Don't call me liar. Game. Okay. As long as we keep an eye on our head on there. I can't word today. As long as we keep an eye on our health, we should be fine. We can counteract the effects of this area just by moving out of it. And then getting some food. See, our health is going up just by eating that. So this is the only way up. Right here. If you go a bit over there or a bit over there, that you won't be able to get up to this area. And actually over here is a really nice spot for Tammy. We can just kite dinosaurs up here. There's nothing in the way blocking our shots, and it can't get up. Not even the T-Rex can get up here. And as you can see by the vegetation up here, we have really everything we need. Up there is snow biome. Oh, hi. Oh, 112. I can't really get into taming you yet. I would like to have you. You just stay in this area. I'm coming back to you. That bugs me a little. And here's the snow biome. So, hi. Ooh, level 72. Oh, there's more of those. Bye. Can't take on all of them. Apple is okay, but not four or five at the same time. That's not a good idea. Oops. You guys still coming? No, that's good. So I'm going in there, try to get the crystal we need to get out of the snow. That's better. And now I'm hot. So if we find a point right in between, we should have our left side boiling and our right side freezing to death. GG game. Good. So like I said, I'm going to try and find some crystal and I'll be back. Alright, we're back. I have no idea if they changed the behavior of crystals. Usually you used to be able to get some at least once in a while with a stone pick. I had to repair this 3 times and I didn't get anything but stone. So I went ahead and got some metal from those big metal nodes in the snow biome while I was at it. And now, I have no idea if this is going to work, but since you are here, you're on passive, right? Yeah, you're on passive. I might just try. I mean, it's a 112, it has a really nice color, it's a bit unusual. We do need one anyway, not just now maybe, but once we get building over there, we need a lot of stone structures. So, you're our stone gatherer. Let's try that. Would you please turn the other way? Hey! Male or female? Female. Again. Just our luck, eh? Come here. Over here. The issue with those guys is, once they take enough damage, they curl up in a ball, and then you can't damage them anymore. Which also means you can't really trank them anymore. Wow! Ow! 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 Stuck? What did you get stuck on? There's only one tree in this direction. I mean, if it was sitting between those two, yeah, maybe, but... Eh? I'm not complaining. Well. Oh, no? Please? No? Okay, well, you're stuck anyway. What we're gonna do is we're gonna head back home. Drop off our metal and that stuff. And then we're gonna come back with some more arrows, some narcotics, some berries, and see if we can get that guy down. Also, gamma up so you can actually see. See, there's flyers everywhere. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the whole area down there, it's like 10, 12 more. Shouldn't have a problem with finding one that we can shoot down. At least we have enough targets to practice on. Once we have arrows. And we're back! So I cleared out all the junk of our inventory. Grabbed our extra bows. And we are almost back to where we were. It's over there. As you can see, here's the cliff. Found this guy. Well, that was easy. There's one more over here. Just want to check its level. Come here. 28. Not much of a difference. I think this guy is 24. Follow. Yes. Female again. Aren't we lucky? So I brought some stuff that we need. For this guy. Let's just get some of those, and I think this should all do. And one stack of this. Just to be on the safe side. There you go, have fun. I like to keep things organized. So, when you tame them, they will eat the best preferred food first. So we have regular meat in here, which they will definitely eat, no problem. But prime meat is preferred over regular meat. So it doesn't matter how I sort this, it's not what's in the first slot, it's what's the best in the inventory. And the game locks up. Thank you. So this is not enough. We have 8 minutes, 2 minutes, 8 minutes. Let's thaw this a bit. This boils first, you go up there. 3, 219. Also, that as well. And then we're down to the 8 minutes. So we'll definitely be able to tame this. It's low level as can be. 24. Barely able to carry us around. But that's all we wanted to do. Carry us around while we explore the area over there. Come on, get going. Let's see how much we get for one prime meat, and then let's see if we need more, because this is like 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 out of this. The rest will spoil. It's about to eat. Down by 50. Let's see. Eat. Eat faster. Oh, that's about a third, almost half. So it will need 3. That should be enough meat in there. So I'm gonna leave you here. Is there anything bad around here? Just killed a Sarko, that's where I got that meat from. On my way back from there to our base. So, that's good. You're not going to attack. There's nothing else here to attack. Let's move on and see if that Dodic is still there. Quite a ways to go. Pretty sure we will miss it taming up. It's not that important. What's important is that we get it. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over there and see if I can find that Dodic again. See if I can shoot it down so it falls unconscious, and then I meet you right back. And we're back! This took a total of, what, 12, 15 more arrows, and then it went down. Perfect. Give me my arrows. Gorgeous. Where are you? There. Put that away. Come over here. that, give me that, and give me one of that. Also, stack, please. Thank you. It's decreasing quite rapidly. 120 is 40 times 3, so let's wait until it's down to 6,000 and then just give it 3. There we go. That should bring it back up to full. Almost. See at the stats before it's tamed. Health needs some work. Stamina, eh, don't really worry about that much for these guys. Food and oxygen, don't, no need to worry at all. Weight needs to go up way higher. Melee damage is okay. Movement speed, eh, not to worry. So, we'll pump weight on this guy. And a little bit of health, definitely. We want to get it up to, well, 5k should be fine. Let's see how fast it goes up. And then we can still decide if we want to have it higher than that. Might bump a little bit of melee just to be able to harvest this little extra out of the resources we have. As you can see, this will take ages. So, you're exactly what I'm looking for. Come on, die, please. Thank you very much. That's exactly what I wanted. So, level up, that's level 35. And look what we got here as our scout. So, all them levels. A little bit more weight. Pteranodon saddle, thank you very much. Now what do we need to do that? Height we have, fiber we have, chitin, keratin might be an issue. Get up there. Never mind, no issue whatsoever. So, that's those 75 plus. 125 fiber there, and 230 hide. You and a little bit of you. And there we go. Rest can go back. So what else do we not need? Jump. Don't die, please. Don't need any of those. See, I've been gathering up some meat here for spoiling. I need to put away stuff. You know what? Why don't you take that for a moment? That. Also been sorting stuff in here a little bit. We can fly away. We don't need that many arrows. You can take these. Might need them later. And the rest doesn't weigh as much except for the spears. Why do we have 4? Usually just carrying around 3. More than enough. 2. Come here. There's that. Weight is not much. That's why we put stuff away so we can actually fly around on this guy. We need to bump our movement speed a little because this is going to be a spout. Spout? Yes, a spout. That's a new word. I just invented it. You heard it here first on Scryptar Plays Games. A scout, of course. And stamina and speed will make most of what we need. So now let's head back over to our Dodic and see what it's doing. Yay, flying! Not really fast. Well, this will still take some time. But we're back here. Worth mentioning, up on this ridge, there's a drop point. Of course, we're going to exploit that as best as we can. I take that, please. Nothing else here I want. It's all primitive stuff. On the way here, I found a drop point. We got something nice, and the most valuable thing on the map, the medium crop plot blueprint. So, no, I don't need any of that. So what I'm going to do is just get rid of this so it can respawn. And then I guess I'm going to sit here for quite a while until we can get this guy home. Yeah, that will still take some time. We've been away for like 10, 12 minutes. And we got, what, 15% maybe? Meet you back! Five, four, three, two, one. Maybe. Today. Maybe not. Wake up. There you go. 165. Not too bad. Not too bad. Scryptar plays games. You were 112 and you're 165. Lovely. Have a look at your stats. We put almost 2 stacks of berries in here. Look at that. That took a while. And it increased food a little, so these berries are going to decrease even more. I don't want that really, but we can get them easily enough, so no worries about that. Torpor is still going up because I pumped quite an amount of narcotics in there. I think it used about 150. So all of which we gather today is gone. Well, that's what we got it for, right? 5,000 health, roughly 1,000 stamina, so we get that definitely up to 1,000. I like round numbers. 380 weight, we need to pump this to a ton, if not more. That's enough melee damage. Movement speed, not too worried about, like I said. It's great. Already learned the engram points for the saddle. Let's have a look. Anything else we learned? The bookshelf, which we're going to need. Where is it? It's not the bookshelf. That's the bookshelf. The bookshelf, which we're going to need fairly soon, once we set up shop on this ridge here, is the next thing we learn. Also took care of the water jar and the sickle to get fiber. Water jar is a good thing to have. As you can see, the water skin leaks water. It says it in the description there. The water jar is heavier, but it's sealed tight. Makes it easy for us. I mean, as long as it keeps on raining. Oh, fog. Nice. That's exactly what you want to have. As long as it keeps raining, we don't have to worry about too much about water, especially with the settings we have on the server. So it's good. You are going to be neutral. Thank you very much. You're following. It's good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get on our flyer, which got a level just by sitting here. And I pump that into a little bit of weight. I don't want to get rid of all my stuff every time I get on this flyer. So we should have about 200. I guess that should be good to have. Currently we're at 27 with all our gear and with good armor. We should be around 100 something. It still needs some food. We might want to carry around some narcotics and stuff like that, or extra arrows for taming. So 200 should be fine. So we're gonna go get down here. Come on, follow. Oh yeah, right, you're stuck. Not anymore, I hope. Yeah, great. Got stuck on that one tree. So, come down here. As long as you're not sitting on it, it doesn't take any fall damage. You can exploit that fairly reasonably. If you fall down while sitting on it, just jump off before you hit the ground and it doesn't take fall damage. And since you just jumped off, you yourself only fall about a couple of feet, so you don't take any fall damage, or at least not as much as if you were jumping from down there. So I'm gonna get this guy back home. Not too overly worried about the saddle at the moment. I'm gonna craft that between episodes and slap it on there. And the next time we meet, we're gonna fly over there, behind that rock, and have a look at that lovely little area. And all the creatures we can get there. There's ankylos, and there's raptors, and there's scorpions, and carnos, and whatnot. Sabertooth. Sometimes a sarco down at the pond there. There's also a drop, as you can see. Not too worried about getting that one right now, but we're going to exploit that drop as well as that drop we had up there. And maybe even that one. We might even fence that off so that we have a fairly secure area there. We will see. Where did you go? Are you stuck somewhere? Did I lose you already? There you are. Come on. Pro tip. Dodex are freaking fast in the water. Best way to get them home, as long as you make sure that there's nothing that will eat them. And here we are! Well, we wanted to get a spyglass and a flyer today. We didn't get the spyglass, but I guess, as a trade-off, a 165 female Dodic is better than a spyglass. So, that's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you soon! Bye-bye!